So One UI 8.5, which will debut on the Galaxy S26 Ultra, just leaked in a hands-on video. And yeah, the iOSification of One UI is still marching forward. But this time, Samsung actually borrowed some genuinely good ideas, so I'm not complaining. Here are 20 new changes, let's get into it. What's up guys, Sal here. So unlike One UI 8, which was more of a minor update, One UI 8.5 is shaping up to be a proper upgrade. Some people already managed to install it on their phones and uncovered a bunch of interesting UI changes. First off, the default dialer app got a major facelift. The tabs per dialer, call log, and contacts no longer stretch across the whole screen. Instead, they sit in a pill-shaped dog at the bottom. The call button even has a subtle drop shadow now, which One UI 8 didn't have. And it's not just the phone app, this floating pill menu shows up system-wide in Quick Share, File Manager, Gallery, basically everywhere. And apparently, Samsung may give us two styles, a standard version and a mini one. The mini is smaller and doesn't have labels. These pills hide when you scroll down and pop back when you scroll up. Another interesting change to the phone app is that AI search is now built in. So instead of scrolling forever, you can just ask it things in plain natural language like who did I talk to last weekend or when did I last call mom. Samsung has already integrated AI search into system settings, and honestly it's one of the best additions they've made, so seeing it expand into more apps is a win. Creating a new contact also looks different, with a smaller card size and better alignment. The calling menu now has these squircle buttons, which honestly don't look that good. A new call assist button is also visible. On top of that, the dialer also gets a new direct voicemail feature, basically iOS 18's live voicemail, showing live transcriptions in real time. If you can't answer, callers can leave a voicemail. You can still pick up all the messages being recorded, and you can also set calls to go straight to voicemail after ringing for a certain time, like 20 seconds. Some carriers already do this, but having it built in is a nice touch. Notification panel has some noticeable upgrade too. The Wi-Fi icon looks bigger, and the panel now uses that fading effect at the top and bottom, which looks way better than the abrupt cutoff in One UI 8. Even better, you can now fully customize the panel, meaning you can literally add or remove anything, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, whatever, making it a lot more flexible. Earlier, it was only limited to this middle section, but now you can add or remove anything over there. The settings app has been redesigned too. The homepage now uses more compact menu items with no subtitle text. The AI-powered search bar floats above the menu, while a persistent search bar sticks at the bottom like iOS 26. Drop shadows are everywhere, on containers, the search bar, and even the back button. Speaking of which, the back button now floats in the top left corner when you scroll, instead of being part of the banner, but only when you scroll. At the top of a page, it snaps back to normal and the header returns. The software update section is also different. The first thing you see is the current One UI version, and the check for updates button has been moved down to the bottom. It's a noticeable change from how it looks in One UI 8. Device care also looks fresh. Instead of thin bars, things like memory, storage, and battery are now shown with wider bars that include percentage numbers. And the little emoji face showing device health? Well, it's gone. It's just text now. The managed storage page has also been redesigned compared to One UI 8. It now has a gradient effect across the layout, and while it's purely visual, it does look better. Galaxy themes got a tweak too. The new look prominently features a large paintbrush icon. Stock app icons, widgets, folders, and the app drawers seem mostly untouched for now, but some builds hint at smaller icon changes. That said, Samsung has a history of tinkering with this right up until the final release, so we'll see what sticks. Across the system, Samsung has also started leaning harder into gradients, Quick Share, My Files, and more. And visually, it actually looks really nice. In My Files, the search bar has been moved to the bottom, where it's easier to reach, and the category tabs now show rounded icons instead of those flat bars. Just below that, the internal storage section now uses a gradient bar design and shows the percentage filled instead of raw storage numbers. Quick Share has been refreshed again, this time with a pixel-style layout that drops a gradient color right in the center. Samsung also threw in a pill-shaped design for the send and receive buttons to tie it all together. Samsung also tweaked the generative edit effects to look like iOS, or should I say similar to circle to search effect when you select an object. Looks really good, so no complaints here. On top of that, Samsung has added some quick action buttons. For example, there is a suggest erase button that automatically highlights objects if things should be removed. There's also an add me option where you can draw and use sketch to image to generate new elements, plus a restyle button that can change the whole look of a photo into things like studio, 3D cartoon, and more. Basically, Samsung has bundled all the Face AI features into one spot, which is smart because you don't have to jump around to find them. Photo editing is getting some upgrades too. There's a new fix-up tool and a suggestion to remove moire when you swipe up on an image. Clock customization has finally been improved as well, with a slider to adjust the font thickness, which should have been there before but wasn't. Now let's talk about some new features in One UI 8.5 that I'm genuinely excited about. First up, One UI 8.5 is testing an AI-powered notification summary, basically identical to what Apple did. Instead of scrolling through multiple notifications from the same app, you get a brief summary. On iOS, sarcasm and slang often get lost, so fingers crossed Samsung does it better. And not only will it summarize, but it will also group notifications based on priority. Again, straight out of iOS's playbook, but this is genuinely useful, so I'm glad Samsung's copying here. Now here's a fan favorite Pixel feature making its way over: automatic call screening. Right now, Samsung phones have Bixby text call, which is manual. You tap to screen the caller and Bixby asks what they want. The new automatic version is smarter. It will kick in for unknown numbers, spam, or spoofed calls and generate a transcript automatically without you lifting a finger. Saved contacts won't be screened and you'll still have the option to trigger the manual Bixby call if you prefer. One UI 8.5 also brings AI to Samsung's modes and routines. Previously, routines were limited to simple actions like opening apps or toggling settings. With One UI 8.5, you'll be able to add Gemini or Bixby as routine actions. That means your phone can trigger AI queries automatically. For example, you can set it up like this, where if you disconnect from work Wi-Fi, your phone can immediately ask Bixby or Gemini for current traffic conditions on your way home. Or if you get a long work email, Gemini can auto-summarize it and send you the key points as a notification. Takes routines to a much smarter level, and if Samsung nails the execution, this could be a game changer. And finally, in One UI 8.5, you can now temporarily disable auto blocker for 30 minutes. After that, it automatically reactivates, which is a solid security move. People often turn auto blocker off and forget to switch them back on, so this solves that without requiring you to remember. So that's where things stand with One UI 8.5 right now. It's a substantial upgrade over One UI 8, and this is still just what surfaced so far. We'll keep learning more as we get closer to Samsung's January Unpacked event, where the Galaxy S26 lineup will officially launch with this software. And for the latest on the Galaxy G Fold and its new UI features, click right here, and I'll see you there.